is a reading from Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar. The kingdoms totter. He utters his voice. The earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought to the earth. He makes war cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow, and shatters the spear. He turns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us, and the God of Jacob is our refuge. Before I start the second reading, I want you to think back on the 1970s, if you remember, and if you were a child up here for a pastor's sermon, you probably don't, but what I thought was amazing in the 70s was some of the music that would cross over. It wasn't really a crossover, because there was really just one pop chart for the most part. So if you were listening to WLS with their transistor up to your ear, or if you were lucky enough to have a farm tractor with a radio mounted while you were plowing or disking furrows or raking hay, there was a group called Ocean. And in 1972, they had a hit called Put Your Hand in the Hand of the Man Who Stilled the Waters. Mm. And this is the scripture on which that is based. On that day, when evening had come, he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with him in the boat, just as he was. Others were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat to the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in the storm, asleep on a cushion, and they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." Then the wind ceased, and there was a dead calm, and he said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?"
Will you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we come striving to hear your words, to hear your message of being more like Christ. So Lord, I ask that you would open our hearts, open up our minds to hear your words, and that the words that I speak now no longer be my own, but they would be your words for your people. All this I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, welcome to you all here and to all of you watching online. As I said, the online views keep climbing, so it is wonderful to see that. But welcome to all of you as we continue on our worship series of The Way. walking in the footsteps of Jesus. We journey through this Lenten season and we strive to see what it means to become more Christ-like in our lives. We've journeyed through Jesus' baptism, temptation, healing ministry, and even through his teaching of the kingdom of God. We've learned through these topics of what it means to live a life which glorifies God and helps us to become more Christ-like. Now today, we journey to places that maybe we don't want to talk about. We travel some of these roads that maybe only our closest friends or family members know about. We turn our focus to the storms in our life. But we also look at the storms in our Gospels to see what insight they may have for Christ-like living. So once again, I encourage you to take out your compass guides as we begin, because here you're going to find those questions that you can reflect on, scripture passages for the week, and that wonderful spot to just jot something down if you need to, or even doodle if it helps you. Maybe you're in the middle of a storm right now. Maybe you've just emerged on the other side of the squall, or maybe you're dealing with some storms in your past. I hope this morning will give you encouragement as you deal with those storms. If you have something that comes up, a question that you would like to ask, just stop by. Give me a call. I would love to listen to you. Now, here's what I want you to take away from today. One, storms will come. There is no escaping them. Two, Jesus may or may not calm those storms that you're in, but keep your eyes focused on him. And three, to be more Christ-like, we need to journey through those storms and then be agents of God's peace to those around us. Now, I don't know if there are any other objects which offer a microcosm of all emotions in life than a boat can offer. I think of many joys. I think of many joys reeling in that record-breaking largemouth bass. I didn't have a record-breaking one, by the way. Or times of exhilaration of skiing behind that wonderful wake, feeling the cool air as it blows and the coolness of the water on a hot summer day. I sense the peace, the stillness of watching the sun rise over that other shore as it reflects off the mirrored surface, all the while slowly breathing in and out, focusing my attention on the awesome God who created all of this. But I can also feel the anxious worry that comes with not necessarily having complete control, as a boat tends to drift. It also has no real brakes on it either. Even the steering is not as controlled as a car or a bike. I can also relate to a couple of stories in our gospel lesson this morning. When a storm whips up and the winds start to blow, making it impossible to steer the boat. The terror that sets in and not having control and the fear of tipping over and not being able to make it to shore for safety. I remember being on Lake Carlisle. I don't know if anybody knows where Lake Carlisle is. Lake Carlisle is in southern Illinois, one of the largest man-made lakes in Illinois. It was the all-college hike for Greenville College, and one of the activities was canoeing. And so a group of friends and I decided that it would be fun to paddle around the lake in a canoe. And so we headed down to the shore, and when we got there, we realized that there were an odd number of people in our group. The canoes were about the size that only two people would fit in. And since I had canoed a number of times before, I told them that it's all right, I'll go ahead and ride by myself. Partway around the lake, the wind picked up. Very similar to our gospel story this morning. We didn't think too much about it because it was at our backs. In fact, it was kind of helping, making it nice. But then it came time to head back to shore. We turned around and began paddling back. Everyone else just seemed to be doing just fine, headed back to shore. But I was having some pretty big problems. I couldn't keep the canoe straight. Every time I would get it pointed to the shore where I wanted to go, the wind would pick up and take me to the left. I couldn't go where everyone else was going. I realized that because of the lighter weight in my canoe, the wind had far more effect on me than it did on the others. It wasn't until I pointed the canoe directly into the wind that I was able to get moving. You see, it was a different path for me to get back to the shore. Took a little more time, but I made it. I needed to go headstrong right into the wind, because if I turned, I risked the boat getting turned either way and getting tipped over by the wind and the waves. This is similar to the storms that we face in our life. When we're in the middle of them, the middle of these storms, we need to keep our eyes focused on God. We need to keep going towards Him, not turning to the left or to the right, because the winds may take us off course. There are two prominent stories in the Gospels about storms out on the Sea of Galilee. In the first, we find the disciples crossing over to the other side after a long day on the preaching circuit. Jesus had been healing so many in his early ministry that people were gathering in great crowds to hear him speak, hoping for more signs and more miracles. So this huge crowd is starting to gather, and Jesus, not wanting to miss this great opportunity, gets into a boat and has his disciples take him offshore just a little bit. Because if you've ever been out on a lake in the middle of a boat and you start talking, you realize that your voice carries quite a bit out on the water. Well, Jesus preaches all day, and evening is coming, so Jesus tells his disciples, let's go to the other side. The other side of this 7 or 8 mile wide lake. Exhausted, the disciples begin the journey. And Jesus was so tired that he fell asleep in the boat. Have you ever noticed that when storms come, they often come when we are in desperate need of rest? We're exhausted and we just want to lay down for a while, and that's when storms arise, testing our reserve, testing our strength, and testing our stamina. The disciples had been listening to Jesus preach all day, and now they're tired, but they're trying to sail the boat to get to the other side of the sea that is known for its unexpected storms. And sure enough, one such storm attacks them, threatening to capsize the boat and kill them all. The other thing I notice here is that storms often come when we travel to do the will of God. The disciples are listening to Jesus. He tells them that they need to go to the other side of the sea. They're going to the other side. They're heading into Gentile territory, taking the message of the kingdom to those who were not of the Jewish faith. God has called each and every one of you to a task. And it's probably different for each of you, but you're called by God for something. It's always been that when we understand our calling and we begin to live into that calling, that the storms come. The devil tries to reach in and keep you from reaching your destination. So here we find the disciples afraid for their lives. They think they're going to die, so they decide that it's time to wake up Jesus. Their comment is, don't you care that we're going to die? You see, there's no request for Jesus to do anything, although I'm sure that it was implied. I love Jesus' response. Peace. Be still. Now, I'm sure that as we look at this, Jesus is telling the wind, peace, or quiet down. And then he looks at the waves and says, be still, calm yourselves. Immediately, the wind and the waves calmed down. The boat rested peacefully on the water, and the disciples took in a deep sigh of relief. They weren't going to die today. But isn't it interesting that those three little words could have been spoken directly to the disciples as well? In fact, those words can be spoken to us in many of our times of storms. Peace. Be still. The disciples, like us in the storms, were probably running around, although you can't run around too much in a boat, but screaming, the sky is falling, the sky is falling. The storms raging all around them, but I'm sure that there were storms also raging within them. Peace. Be still. Are we not the same way? We just lost a job. We just found out that our spouse has been cheating. Our kids are experimenting with drugs or alcohol. We don't have enough to pay our bills. And then you throw in the state of the world today. It makes us anxious, fearful, unsure of our future. And then we try to tell ourselves that all is well, that everything will be all right. And it starts out okay, maybe, but it quickly turns south. I'm reminded of a scene in a movie that I want to show you in just a second here. A certain movie scene that starts out, all is well. So go ahead, Steve.
Remain calm. All is well. All is well. Remain.
If we try to do this ourselves, we end up like Kevin Bacon here, screaming that all is well when everything else is going crazy around him. What we really need to do is listen to Jesus in those times. Peace. Be still. And those words may come from those whom he has sent, people who are close to us. Maybe these words are words that you need to speak to someone that you know. We need to be agents of God's peace in the midst of storms. There's a story about a farmer who owned land along the Atlantic seacoast. He constantly advertised for hired hands. Most people were reluctant to work on those farms along the Atlantic. They dreaded those awful storms that rage across, wreaking havoc on buildings and crops. As the farmer interviewed applicants for the job, he had a steady stream of refusals. And finally, a short, little, thin man, well past middle age, approached the farmer. Are you a good farmhand? The farmer asked. Well, I can sleep when the wind blows. Although puzzled by this answer, the farmer, desperate for help, hired him. The little man worked around the farm, busy from dawn till dusk, and the farmer felt satisfied with this man's work. And then, one night, the wind howled loudly in from offshore, one of those storms raging off the Atlantic. Jumping out of bed, the farmer grabbed a lantern and rushed next door to the hired man's sleeping quarters, and he shook the little man and yelled at him and said, "Get up, get up! The storm is coming. Tie things down before they blow away." The little man rolled back over in bed and said firmly, "No, sir, I told you, I can sleep when the wind blows." Enraged by the old man's response, the farmer was tempted to fire him right on the spot. Instead, though, being that it was his farm, he hurried outside to prepare for the storm. To his amazement, he discovered that all the haystacks were covered in tarps. The cows were in the barn, chickens were in the coop, and the doors were barred. The shutters were tightly secured. Everything was tied down. Nothing could blow away. The farmer then understood what his hired hand meant when he said that he could sleep when the wind blew. And he returned to bed also to sleep while the wind blew. Jesus may not calm the storm that you're in right now, or even the ones that are going to come your way. But he will calm the storm in you. Listen when he tells you, peace, be still. Let him hold you in his hands until the storm passes by. Go ahead. In the dark of the midnight, have I oft hid my face while the storm howls above me and there's no hiding place. Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry and keep me safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky and hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand, keep me safe till the storm passes. When the long night has ended and the storms come no more, let me stand in thy presence on that bright, peaceful shore, in that land where the tempest never comes. Lord, may I dwell with thee when the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, clouds roll forever from the sky and hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand, keep me safe till the storm. Heavenly Father, hold us in the palm of your hands. We may be facing storms right now, but even if we're not, Lord, we know that storms are coming. Keep us safe. Keep us protected until those storms pass by. And in the midst of those storms outside of us, speak to our hearts and tell us, peace, be still. Allow us to truly feel your peace that you give, because you give not as the world gives. You give us a peace that passes all understanding. speak to us. Speak peace into our lives this day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.